10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Lift off, detected.
There's motion.
This one has cleared the tower.
Trajectory continues to look good, seeing good data quality coming down from the vehicle. Body rate response
great to hear
phenomenal.
That good data quality.
All seven engines continue
looking
to look
nominal.
Good.
Next up, Miko, which is main engine cutoff. The cheers are real. You can hear them all the way in here.
And we have Miko.
And we have Miko.
We have good stage set.
We have good stage separation!
And we have ignition, stage two. Both engine parameters look good.
Stage two ignition! Oh, you see the two rockets there!
Body rate stamping out nicely. Both BPU engines look good at the high thrust set point. Body rate responses look good. 3 minutes, 43 seconds into flight.
Great shots. Look at that view.
We have good indication of payload frame jettison. Both B3U engines continue to look good. Body rate responses normal. Seeing good data coming down from both stages.
Great data. We're 4 minutes into NG2. Alright, at 9 minutes is when we're expecting the first stage to touch down on Jacqueline.
Approximately 2 minutes remaining in the GS1 coast.
for joining us for NV2. So far, a nominal mission.
TS2 has got 320 kilometers sound range, traveling at 2.8 kilometers per second. Trajectory continues to look good on both stages.
Clean separation, clean fairing.
Right down the middle of the range track. Engine operating parameters on TS2 look good.
It sounds like our TS2 is having a beautiful ride. The NASA Escapade satellites are exposed to space right now. And we've got GS1 coming down for landing at T+9 minutes.
Remaining in the GS1 coast. Continue to see good data coming down from both GS1 and GS2. Body rates on both stages look good. The 3U engines look good.
Everything looking good, looking nominal.
Seeing good TV
CMR control. And on this moment coming up is an important one.
It is. We're going to relight the BE-4 engines for the re-entry burn.
Engine only out on GS1. Exo-turn is complete.
There you go. It's about 300,000 feet, less than 100 kilometers up there, coming in for a landing on the deck and 375 miles offshore, waiting for the first time to land Blue Origin's new Glenn booster on the Jacqueline.
Now halfway to the left.
Less than 45